must stay at home.
This is what Russian President Vladimir Putin unleashed on Ukraine.
The United Nations has warned the war in Ukraine could cause global food shortages.
It's food bills, energy bills, fuel prices. With inflation now at 9%, many families are struggling to cope.
And for many Britons, it means a real cut in living standards, because wage increases have been held to only 5% since the middle of 1975.
Some 50,000 railway workers are expected to take industrial action. There she goes.
This chaos comes as travel disruption continues at UK airports as well.
74 universities are involved in 2 weeks of strikes.
There are warnings of a winter of discontent.
That we have hundreds of thousands of vacant nursing posts right across the country. We are draining staff from our healthcare services every single solitary day.
Strikes by ambulance men and hospital ancillary staff soon meant that nearly half the country's hospitals could handle emergencies only.
This will be the biggest strike on Britain's railways since the 1980s.
And the country faced the very real prospect of food shortages.
This was a year-long resistance by the bulk of the miners and their families.
But most damaging of all to the government's image was the strike by the refuse men.
Owing to industrial action over the government pay policy, which means that we've now come to the end of this Sunday evening here on 2.
Because of an industrial dispute by electricians at the studios of Granada Television.
Up in Liverpool, even the gravediggers had gone on strike.
Harold Macmillan won an election on the slogan, "You've never had it so good."
We have never had it so good.
Crisis? What crisis?
It suggests that energy blackouts impacting 6 million households could start before the end of the year and would last for 3 months.
The country, already suffering from a particularly savage winter, now faced paralysis.
They've been without mains electricity for 3 days.
The price of staple foods has soared in recent months.
Petrol increased by 300%.
We start with a warning about possible winter blackouts.
When the nation was literally threatened with disaster, the power cut was ordered.
The government has already imposed a ban on the use of electricity for street lighting and advertising.
As the dispute worsened, the cabinet were once again faced with the prospect of declaring a state of emergency.
The National Grid has conceded that 3-hour cuts may be necessary if it can't cope with demand.
Firing up coal power plants could be one contingency measure.
How dare you!
The ban now also includes heating in offices, shops, public halls, and places of entertainment.
Here at the largest candle makers in Britain, they've doubled production to 1.5 million candles a day.
4 candles.
In ironmongers, it's always the same notice, and orders for fresh supplies have been in for days.
In places where work could be done, it was done by the flickering light of candles.
To avoid this, the grid has got 5 coal-fired power plants on standby, as well as a new publicity campaign ready to launch in November, encouraging businesses and consumers to use less power during peak times.
And may I say how much I admire the housewives of Britain in these appalling present conditions for their courage in trying to give their families another super Christmas.
Industry needs power. At home, you could get by with less. So switch off some power now.